Good afternoon, students. Today our topic is flexor compartment of forearm. So as you already know, forearm is the region of upper limb which extends from the elbow joint above and the wrist joint below. So forearm has two regions or two compartments. Anterior compartment is also known as flexor compartment, and the posterior compartment, which is known as extensor compartment. So today we'll discuss the flexor compartment. Flexor compartment has two group of muscles. We have superficial group of muscles and deep group of muscles. So superficial, we have five muscles, and there are three deep muscles of flexor compartment of forearm. So as you already know, we have dissected the skin, superficial fascia and deep fascia of this region already. We have shown you the cubital fossa, the boundaries and its contents. And today we'll discuss the flexor compartment, only the superficial part. So today we'll discuss only superficial muscles of flexor compartment of forearm. First of all, we will enumerate the muscles of superficial compartment. What are the muscles of superficial compartment? We will start from lateral to medial side. Lateral to medial side. This muscle here is pronator teres muscle. This muscle is pronator teres muscle. This muscle is forming the medial boundary of cubital fossa. This is cubital fossa here. So this muscle is pronator teres. It is forming the medial boundary of cubital fossa. Then medial to this pronator teres muscle, this muscle here is flexor carpi radialis. This is flexor carpi radialis muscle. Medial to this muscle, we have palmaris longus muscle. This muscle here is palmaris longus muscle. This palmaris longus muscle has long tendon, as you can see here, this long tendon and short belly. This is the short belly of palmaris longus muscle. Then further medial to this palmaris longus, we have this big muscle here. This muscle is called flexor digitorum superficialis muscle. This is flexor digitorum superficialis muscle. Then more medial to this muscle, we have this is flexor carpi ulnaris muscle. This is flexor carpi ulnaris muscle. So these are five muscles from lateral to medial. First was pronator teres. This is small muscle here, pronator teres, which is forming the medial boundary of cubital fossa. Then flexor carpi radialis. Medial to this we have palmaris longus muscle, the muscle having long tendon and short belly. Then we have big muscle here, flexor digitorum superficialis. Then flexor carpi ulnaris muscle. So lateral to medial, five muscles. Now further, we will discuss origin and insertions of these muscles. The first muscle of flexor, superficial flexor compartment, was pronator teres. The pronator teres has two heads. It originates from humerus and also from ulna. So it has humeral head and ulnar head. So this head, these fibers coming from the humerus, it is coming from the medial epicondyle of humerus. So this humeral head of pronator teres is coming from the medial epicondyle of humerus. Medial epicondyle of humerus is also known as common flexor origin. It is also known as common flexor origin because most of the muscles of flexor compartment, they take origin from this medial epicondyle. So this is common flexor origin. So the humeral head of pronator teres, ये जो ऊपर दिख रहा है, this superficial head of pronator teres, it is coming from the humerus, medial epicondyle of humerus. It also has ulnar head. This is the ulnar head of pronator teres. This ulnar head of pronator teres coming from the medial border of coronoid process of ulna. It is coming from the medial border of coronoid process of ulna. both heads will join together and will insert into the middle of lateral aspect of radius. It will insert into the lateral aspect of middle of shaft of radius. So this was the pronated teres. It has humeral head and ulnar head. So between these two heads, there passes a structure which is median nerve. So between these two heads, there passes a nerve called median nerve. दोनों हेड के बीच में एक नर्व पास करती है विच इज कॉल्ड मीडियन नर्व. सो दिस वॉज पोनेटेड टीरीज टेकिंग ऑरिजिन फ्रॉम ह्यूमरस अल्ना एंड विल इंसर्ट इन टू द मिडल ऑफ द शेफ्ट ऑफ रेडियस. नाउ कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट मसल, दिस इज द फ्लेक्सर कार्पाई रेडियलिस मसल. दिस फ्लेक्सर कार्पाई रेडियलिस मसल टेक्स ऑरिजिन फ्रॉम द कॉमन फ्लेक्सर ऑरिजिन विच इज मीडियल एपिकुंडाइल ऑफ ह्यूमरस and running downwards, and it will insert into the base of second and third metacarpal. Base of second and third metacarpal. We have not dissected this hand region yet, so you are unable to see the insertion part. So it will insert into the base of second and third metacarpal. This was flexor carpi radialis muscle. Radialis means it is running toward the radial side. Now coming to the next muscle, which is palmaris longus muscle. This muscle has long tendon and short valley, and it takes origin again from medial epicondyle of humerus, which is common flexor origin, and running downwards, and it will insert on the flexor retinaculum. Flexor retinaculum, I think it is the modification of the fascia, and also to the palmar epineurosis of hand. Palmar epineurosis of hand, we haven't dissected this part yet. So origin was from medial epicondyle of humerus and insertion into flexor retinaculum and palmar epineurosis. Now coming to the next muscle, which is the big muscle. This is flexor digitorum superficialis. This flexor digitorum superficialis has two heads. One head is called humero-ulnar head and other head is called radial head. So humero-ulnar head will takes origin from humerus and ulna. So on the humerus, it takes origin from the medial epicondyle of humerus, which is common flexor origin, and ulnar part of this head will takes origin from the medial border of coronoid process of ulna. And its radial head, as you can see here, these are the fibers of radial head. These fibers are coming from the anterior oblique line of radius, shaft of radius. Anterior oblique line of shaft of radius. They will join, and finally this muscle will divide into four tendons. As you can see here, it will divide into four tendons. These tendons run toward the palm and finally up to the digits. So these four tendons further divide into two slips. These slips will insert into the side of middle phalanx of medial four digits or second to fifth digits. So each tendon will further divide into two slips, which will insert onto the side of middle phalanx of second to fifth digit. So this was the insertion of flexor digitorum superficialis muscle. Now coming to the fifth muscle, which is flexor carpi ulnaris muscle. This is flexor carpi ulnaris. As name indicates, it runs in relation with ulna or toward the ulnar side. It takes origin from two heads. One is humeral head, other is ulnar head. Humeral head will takes origin from the medial epicondyle of humerus, which is common flexor origin, and the ulnar head will takes origin from the medial border of olecranon process of ulna, medial aspect of olecranon process of ulna, and runs downwards, and it will insert into the pisiform bone here, which is carpal bone, pisiform bone, and it is prolonged up to the hook of hamate and base of fifth metacarpal. So it will insert into the pisiform bone, further extend up to the hook of hamate and base of fifth metacarpal. So this was the origin and insertion of flexor carpi ulnaris muscle. So these were the origin and insertion of flexor superficial muscles. So we will have a quick revision of these muscles now. First of all, we start from lateral to medial side. First muscle is pronator teres, which is forming the medial boundary of cubital fossa. This muscle originates from, it has two heads, originate from medial epicondyle of humerus, and the ulnar head originate from the medial border of coronal process of ulna. So it will insert into the lateral aspect of shaft of radius. Next muscle is flexor carpi radialis. Origin is from medial epicondyle of radius, insertion into the second and third metacarpal, base of second and third metacarpal. Next is palmaris longus muscle, long tendon, short valley, origin from medial epicondyle of humerus and will insert into the flexor retinaculum and palmar epinosis of palm. Next is the big muscle, again has two heads, humeroulnar head, humeral part will come from medial epicondyle of humerus, ulnar part is coming from medial border of coronal process of ulna, and the radial head which will originate from the anterior oblique line of shaft of radius, anterior oblique line of shaft of radius. It will divide into four tendons. Each tendon will further divide into two slips, which will insert into the side of middle phalanx of second to fifth digit. So this was the insertion of flexor digitorum superficialis muscle. Next is flexor carpi ulnaris muscle. Again, it has two heads, the humeral head and ulnar head. Humeral head is coming from the medial epicondyle of humerus. Ulnar head is coming from the medial aspect of olecranon process of ulna. And running downwards, it will insert into the pisiform bone, hook of hamate and base of fifth metacarpal bone. So this is the all about the muscles of flexor compartment, the superficial muscles of flexor compartment. Thank you so much.